Hello, hello, greetings and good evening. Hey everyone. Tonight, I welcome you to the invasion of Germany with the British tea bag. Hey, Mad Panda, how are you? So tonight the sound difficulties should be better again. Last time I had the microphone the other way around, so this time it should be better. Watcher is here. Hello, Grief. Hey, Lucas. Peter. Hey, mic is working better. Awesome. Just if it's too loud, let me know. It's just it seems that every stream I change something. Okay, server should be going online any minute now. So we are in for Nürburgring, and there are speculations that it could be raining. And gonna be interesting. The watcher hasn't done any practice. I just did practice in the dry, and I felt really good in the Bentley actually. I did my personal best with a 56.2, I think. But I just practice dry weather. So let's see how that goes. The Monkos is also here. Andy is also here. Hey, nice to see you all. So, there's still no server there. Hello. Server. So. Hey, the Mongo's awesome. I hope you learned something helpful there. By the way, we can listen into the driver's briefing if you want.
I suggest you take a look at it so you don't get a penalty. Take it easy into turn one and the arena section, especially first two laps, because otherwise it will be carnage. It's braking zone, so just be careful.
Look at that, it's raining,
I'm a
of
bit
course.
unprepared today. I wasn't really. I was thrown in last minute again. So, Dan, anything you want to add?
Blue flags, respect them. It's wet, so be careful. And that's about it, I think.
All right.
If you need to be familiarised with anything else, then the rule book's in the rule book chat, and as long as everyone stays to that, then happy days.
All right. Mad Panda, I really enjoy the Bentley. I share some setups on my Discord, and yeah. As expected, the rumors were true. So, are we gonna use. Let's see. Let's do these settings. Let's give TC6 and ABS7 a try. And I have to focus now on the white tire pressures and see if it's wet enough. There's only been one time I've been racing Nürburgring in the wet. And it's half a year ago, basically. So this is gonna be interesting. So tonight we'll be all around surviving to prevent any carnage. It's been a long time since I've driven in really wet conditions, but the benefit with the Bentley is that it actually feels very planted. That's, I think, why it got the nickname of Boatley. And I'm pretty sure that it will catch a lot of drivers off guard because the practice server for all our splits here with AC CSS have been dry. So, I guess a lot of people will be struggling today. So the important thing now is to balance the wet tires. And not overdo it, basically. So wet tire pressure should be around 30 psi, and you can see that it's already too much. And the question is, will this rain persist through race? But since we are only racing 30 minutes with a pit stop, I think I will take the risk with going wet tires. Because it doesn't really matter if they get too hot or rub off too much, because I can always change on the fly. Bentley and Lexus will have a chill day. Practical difference between the two Bentley is actually a good action. I've never tried the other one. It's just an older model, so it might be that the, you know, from perspective of balance of power, it's a bit off. So there's like basically not as much potential in there as like with the 2018, the new one. Oh, Pete, you were there for the race. T1, remember. Sounds like 9/11, remember. T1, remember. I'm just not sure right now which part of the curbs I should ignore. And which ones I should be careful. Okay, I need to be lift more here or even brake a little bit. But braking feels good so far. Oh, you were in the Porsche 911, okay. That's why it stuck with you. The memory. Ooh, this track. This turn is really nasty in the wet.
Slow car ahead.
Need to brake a little bit earlier there. But yeah, wet tires are overcooking already. Oh, there's Tweedy in the partner livery. So I might just go back into the pits now. Just park it here. Because the wet tire pressures are starting to explode. It might be that it's not raining enough. It's also not that cold, actually, I wonder. Just open up this. Let's see, I'm just gonna go down two full PSI now, because I opened the brake ducts. The brake ducts. 25.6 or something. Let's check that. Fuel consumption was now 2.70. Let me just quickly put that in. Question is now, what lap time can we expect in this weather? I think we can even do a bit lower ABS and TC. Well, ABS felt good. I think we can do a bit less traction control. Captain Orlix, how are ya? Drove the Lambo on Monza. Best lap ever, nice. Congratulations. Always feels good when you do a personal best, right?
flying in sector 2.
Okay, let's keep an eye now on the wet pressures and temperatures. Careful there. Forty-one people on the server, so that's gonna be really important to keep cool at the start and evade all the chaos that's gonna ensue in what weather conditions in the first lap. Ooh, this one's really a nasty one. As it looks now, I'm pretty sure that the ideal race line will dry up. At least after the pit stops. The way it looks like now, but I don't know, I just don't want to go for slicks honestly, because that just makes it so much worse. But yeah, the wet tires are overheating. Again, you see that they're just overheating.
There's a slow car, man.
Tricky, tricky. Hey, Jürgen. I'm not sure if it's a good idea to go with wets. I mean, there is some standing water in some turns, and then in some other turns not. Yeah, I think I'm gonna try the dry tires as well. I have to try them, but the dry tires are a huge gamble. But I just have to try them and save a preset, because you never know what happens in qualifying and the race. Yeah, I know. It's just I don't like it. Because driving with dry tires in these conditions means I have to avoid all the curbs and be so ultra careful. I enjoy it in wets much more. But seeing the tire temperatures, there's like, yeah, no choice, because they will be cooked after a few laps. Even though I'm basically just driving 15 minutes and then have a pit stop. To see what time I can do with this. Yeah, but the track's definitely drying up. It's not raining enough. You can get a puncture if you can over. If you can, I think, even make the tire explode. Okay. So, we need to switch to that. Question is now, do I take my dry setup or not? Probably. You know what, let's just give it a try. And with this we need to really blow it up. I would actually, let's just do this one to 29.5. I'm just overcooking them now and then see how much I need to decrease them. Hachemi, there's huge differences of ACC and AC actually. The whole force feedback, I think, is completely different. Yes, Jorgen, I know, I just now I need to experiment because there's not much time. And let's just see. Let's see. Now we have to be really careful. Thanks, Glenn. Thank you so much for stopping by. Really tricky conditions. I mean, it's not my first race in conditions like that. I'll just let the guy pass. I had conditions like these. Oh boy, I can't remember even. I think Misano with the Mercedes. And you can already see how cold the tires get, so I need to blow them up even more.
Car on the left. Clear on the left.
Usually sometimes in these conditions you have to blow them up to like 30, 31-ish. Oh, okay. Because they are now going below 27, even below 26 soon. No, they won't get warm, but the problem is I need 27 PSI at least. You can see now that the left front is getting way too low. I have no grip. So let's just engine map 2. With the Bentley it's not so tragic, but let's see now. Let's give it a proper dry. Oh great, now the cat is sitting in front of the cam. You have the kitty cam now, guys. She never did that, that's actually the first time she's doing that. Jesus, feels horrible actually. Additional entertainment provided by Luis, one of our two cats. He always likes to get in the middle of it all, you know? So the car felt definitely much better with the wet tires. But that's for sure. That's completely normal. Here as well. I think it might even be better in qualifying if it has the same conditions to just do a quick lap in wet tires. I don't know, it's really tricky.
Car on the
Video bombing. Catertainment. So the pressures are starting to get better. Still way too slow through these corners. I'm losing a second already in the first sector. I'm not sure, it doesn't feel really good right now. I can't get wet tires on because they will be cooked.
Yellow flag in sector one.
Woohoo! This is one of the situations I was really afraid of. I either go for now really with wet, with dry tires and drive very, very passive in the first few laps, like really very, very passive, and just hope that everybody crashes out. Or I take the wets, but the wets won't hold. Cat! Get lost! Seems that today this is going to be her favorite place of all places. Yeah, I guess the wets will be the wrong decision. It's just, I mean, we're just driving 30 minutes with a pit stop, so I have time. If I take the, you know, if I have not enough pressure or pressures are wrong, I can easily adapt that. I just think that I need to be very, very passive with these slicks. I'm not jealous of my kid.
Yellow flag in sector one. Yellow flag ahead, be careful.
The problem is here is too much water, so you need to be very careful. One full PSI increase, yeah, yeah. That's what I'm planning to do now. Just gotta practice the pit entry. But for the qualifying, for just one or two laps, I'm gonna have to take the wets. I will rock this, thank you. So let's just do one full PSI more here. Thirty point five. 4. Okay. No, this is closed down. That's good. Not messing with anything else. So now the pace was like really... So let's save this. Greasy. I'm sorry that if you kind of noticed that I'm not as talkative today as I'm usually are, but I don't want to drag anyone down, but today is one of these lockdown days where your mood is just... But trying my best here to lighten up, so just be patient with me. Let's save it with this again. Okay. And for the qualifying, we are gonna switch, I think, to the wet ones. Punt someone and you'll feel better. Thanks for the idea, Daniel. No, it's just really, today is one of these tough days where it's just, you get up in the morning and you're like, nah, I can't do that today. So I just need some estimation of times. 2:11, 2:12, Jesus. How should one calculate fuel with that? That's so tricky. Tricky, tricky, tricky. This is one of the challenges in sim racing, you know? It's just... That's just part of the challenge which makes it interesting. But can be frustrating. I'm located in Vienna, Martin. Oh, thank you so much, Neil. Send it into T1, it's Carthatic.
Yellow flag, be careful there. Yellow flag in sector 3.
Okay, it's easier to just reset. We are still in lockdown, and I think we will be in longer lockdown if it continues like that, because everybody starts panicking because of this British virus stuff. And yeah. So Monday is press conference. Zico, where are you from? Oh look, there's Tweety. Did not have my TC and ABS adapted, because from the dry setup it puts it to 3, so I need to adjust it on the wheel to again recalibrate it to where I want it. Now it works properly.
There's a slow car up ahead. Yellow flag, be careful.
Oh, from Britain, Neil. Sorry, from Britain. Drive the British car for the British virus mutation. Michigan, Seiko, okay. Well, I think in America the situation is completely different, right? So here in Europe it's really not so fun. And I think here in Austria they are really... Yeah. But we will know more on Monday. But in the meantime, let's just cheer each other up. That's what the stream is actually for. Just keep it entertaining and positive. Oh, UK lockdown 15th of Feb, holy crap. Oh, engine mapping is again on 8. Holy crap, the car is wild. We are in for a wild ride tonight, guys. If my mic is too loud, just let me know, because it keeps kind of bouncing into the red right there. Yeah, let's not get into politics. That's like, I hate that. Politics just ruin everything, so let's just keep it fun. Except race politics, you can talk about Formula One decisions or whatever. So let's keep it corona free and keep it positive and keep it fun. We are sitting in the same boat. In the British teabag. As I would lovingly call it, it's a huge British teabag. And it's dipping into German waters, so perfect. We will have some British Gulf tea today. Holy crap. I wonder if anyone will drive in wet. If anyone's kind of taking the risk. Who's gonna wet and who's gonna dry? Because unfortunately we can't really see that in the timetables. It would be really interesting to see who is going with wet or dry tires. Okay, at least pressures look a bit better now. Oh, the new Netflix TV season would be cool. I would bet like kinda... Was there any news about it? I just heard they were filming season 3 now, right? In the last year in the Formula 1. I enjoyed both the first seasons, so maybe... In spring? Maybe in spring. I would guess in spring sometime. Holy shamoli. I now did forget to save the wet preset with the tire pressures for the qualifying, but let's see how the qualifying is. Oh, holy crap, that lap time is bad now. So with the wet, with the dry tires in these conditions, I'm around 3 seconds slower than with the wet tires. But now the tire pressures look better. We are teabagging the Germans today. Germany is now Sky Formula 1, okay. The Haas team director is the favorite. Yeah, he's a funny guy. Is he from Switzerland? I think he's a Swiss guy, right? Team Haas, but for sure they had some unwanted attention because of Marzipan or however he's called. I call him Marzipan. Okay, qualifying same conditions, but holy crap, look at the temperatures, much too warm. Jesus. So we have 15 minutes now as amateur split. I don't know what to, I can't go out in slicks with that. Let me just try the wet preset. See what happens. Let's just try that. Because for one or two laps it should be good. The medical sounding name, the medicine sounding name guy. What? So I'm just using the wet tires now because the track now is full wet. And this should be good for maybe two fast laps, if possible. And then let's see. Because with slicks it would just be a slide fest right about now. See if I nailed the pressures. I think, I don't know about Lewis Hamilton, he kind of declined their first offer with like 40 million euros or something, and I was like, yeah, sure. I know the guy is a really good driver and a champion, but I mean, come on. He always talks about like fairness and being whatever, reasonable, and then he declines like a ridiculous offer, 40 million euros. I mean, on the one hand, I understand him. On the other hand, I'm like, Jesus, dude. There should be like a budget limit to driver salaries. But yeah, there's always two sides to that, so. No one knows, according to rumor. Nice. What would be Formula One without Lewis Hamilton? I don't think they are going to let this happen. So he will get place pretty sure in either Mercedes or somewhere else, but who wants to pay that much money, especially now in these troubling times? Yellow flag ahead. Mazepin, that's the name, Mazepin. Increase the traction control by a click and it's still going crazy.
Yellow flag, be careful.
I think I nailed it.
Yellow flag is sector one.
With tire pressures. Not so good through there. It feels so much better with wet tires right now. But I'm sure they won't last. I mean, my split time will only be like 15 minutes. But I'm pretty sure I can't make them live that long. I don't know. I'm really unsure right now. Because the race is so damn short. DD1 wheel settings. Look in the Reddit and probably the official forum, either Fanatec or Kunos. Because I would love to give you settings, but I don't have a DD1. Oh, really bad. But yeah, like, I thought wet tires are now overheating. You got a DD1, congratulations, dude. That's an amazing upgrade. Still gonna try it. White tires are getting a bit too warm now, but I'm still trying for a lap because I don't care. I can just have no mercy with the wet tires now because they don't need to last anyway. So try the official forums, or the Fanatec forums, or the ACC Reddit. You can also try to YouTube, because I think there are quite a few YouTubers using the DD1 with ACC. So they might have some settings to share. So yeah. I'm even inclined to do another lap on wet tires. After lowering. Because I don't have to be careful with the tires. Yes, really good improvement there.
Cut detected.
So I'm gonna just try it again. Just lowering the pressures a tiny bit. Whoops. I thought aftershave and it did nothing for the lap times. I think you got the wrong aftershave there. Boosted Media, yes, that's a huge channel for like everything related to sim racing gear. Thank you for the suggestion, Peter. You can even put a link to it in the chat, there's no problem. Don't mind that. So I'm still on the wets, because for qualifying now the track is just too wet. I'm still not sure about the race, but it's just after three laps the tires are basically cooking, so you can see they are already starting to completely heat up. Let's just see if I can squeeze out some more seconds. Let's see some more tenths. Just got the normal CSL Elite wheelbase. I wonder how direct drive would feel to me. But if I'm honest, I'm not sure if I would get a Fanatec one. Are there like many other manufacturers doing cool steering wheels for Fanatec DDs, or is it mostly for Simo Cube? Because I'm really looking into like Simo Cube, but I mean, they're just too expensive, but that would be like either the thing I would looking into, because they have so many cool steering wheels. I mean, the Fanatec one is also really incredible, so I think it wouldn't matter. It's just, you know, if you have money to spare. That was very late there. Whew. Wasn't sure I'm gonna make that turn. Please, please, please stay. Losing there. Okay, that was a bit too much. And somebody killed their 100 meter board there. so I didn't see that. Holy crap. You can do one more. Oh, graph, that's completely fine. I started with the G29. So better than nothing, you can race. That's cool. And believe me, it's a really good teacher having a wheel and pedals like that. If you upgrade at some point, it will just feel like a blessing to you. Believe me. It's like... yeah. So just stick with it. Be patient. Was a bit too early on brakes. Whoa, losing half a second here.
Yellow flag in sector one.
I feel like this is kind of the limit, but... This is it for today, my guys. Only 1 minute left. It doesn't get any better from here. I wonder what Burnswood was driving. 1.5 second off the time, so that's horrible. Well, at least most of the people were starting. I think here everyone is on wets. Not sure if he was on slicks, I just can't imagine it. The track right now was just too wet for slicks. Consistency is the key, Graf. Consistency and having fun, because then you will improve. So that's really good. Just, you know, stick with it. It's night and day and I'm still rubbish. Just takes time. Over 600 hours in and you still see me struggling, stuff like that. So let's see who from the who from the pros will be the first one to leave the pits, because they are allowed to leave now, I think. Dan Terry, of course. So let's check what Dan Terry is doing. And we have now 15 minutes of time left, everyone, so welcome to Dr. Boonetics. Please, have a seat on the couch. Just tell me what are you feeling currently. Your deepest thoughts, emotions. So that was tricky. You can see there a little bit how the track is starting to dry up. So when going with slick tires, this will be a huge challenge to like really stay on that line. Because interesting fun fact is the game is not rendering where most of the cars are driving and adapting the dry line. It is a pre-rendered dry line and it will always be like that. No matter if like 40 cars lap by lap use a different line in the turn, it will always keep the pre-programmed, pre-rendered dry line. So that's an interesting fact. So you kind of have to adapt and follow that line to make the best out of it. And yeah, so that's probably interesting to know for you guys. Love the video and the liver is very helpful. Awesome. Don't forget to hit the like button. Yes. Thanks, captain. Captain, you really want to be a moderator, don't you? So then Terry's still the first one out. The 602 car was a GT4. If you want like another perspective, just let me know. or if you want to see anyone else as well, let me know. We have Paul Kramp Daily, Chris Meadows is here, then Terry Thorpe, Doherty, so a few names. Paul Gatrix is also here, so yeah. I really enjoyed the first race on Mount Panorama, actually. I just loved that. That was incredible. It's one of my favorite tracks right now, actually. And Domonkos, I don't want to think about that, but I'm pretty sure there will be some highlight potential. I'm just really concerned right now, because usually, most of the time, I'm in the middle of Code Brown moments, and if I'm really starting with slick tires, I really don't know, but I have to start with slick tires. I mean, the benefit is that I won't need a lot of fuel, probably. Just barely 40 liters. So I'm inclined to just start with this. 19 degrees was the track, and now it's 8 degrees more. So we just keep that. I could start with like 25 and then just refuel 20. And pressures are correct here. Yeah. So this would be the starting set, like dry tires with a little bit less pressure. Yeah, like this. So this is kind of what I'm thinking about doing right now. And so far only Paul Crump was able to do a valid lap. Oh, and Henley. So looks like the guys are struggling. I wonder if they are already going on with slick tires. Take it as a learning experience. That's a good plan. Hey, Sam. Nice to see you back. How are you doing? I hope you have a great evening or day wherever you are. Domonkos, I like your way of thinking. It's just take it as a learning experience. Races like these should always be, you know what, should always be taken lightly, because in these conditions, so much can go wrong. I'm pretty sure Dan is on slick tires, as it looks right now. So he's really struggling. Let's look at what else is going on here. Chris Meadows in the new AMG also seems to struggle. So that's gonna be interesting. You can really clearly see now the dry line there. It's just which one is the cam. Not so good. Having a great day, awesome. At least someone has a great day. Mine's not as great today. Not such a good mood, but anyway, let's keep on racing. And how's the racing? As you can see, difficult. We are in for a challenge, and we are throwing the British teabag into German waters today. And oh, again invalidating his lap. So look at that, we just had two pro drivers splitting up the top. So a lot of them are struggling. I'm pretty sure they are all going out with slicks now in these conditions, and for a short amount of qualifying, that's actually, as we saw, a mistake. If you just go like two or three laps in these conditions and the track is still semi-wet, you will have a better time with wet tires, as they just start overheating after like two laps, and you can put in your flying lap and it's fine, like I did. And now they are just having a really rough time, actually. Oh, he did not invalidate. It looks like he invalidated. So we just have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So a bunch of drivers is still 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 pro drivers, 8 pro drivers without any time. crushing the Germans. Let's crush the rebellion with our station of destruction. I just tried to do like the Tarkin, watching too much Star Wars Rebels right about now. So I might not be having such a hard time at the grid then. Okay, we have another Bentley. Can really nicely see the dry line there right now. What are the guys' times actually right now? I 2:02 in these conditions. Crazy lap time. Mine was a 2:04. 2:05. 2:06. So yeah. Boy oh boy, I'm really afraid. Really concerned. The race pace with slick tires in the start. It's gonna be interesting. Let's see where Mr. Grindover will be done. You're in an avid Battlefront 2 player. I'm really hyped now because Lucasfilm games or LucasArts games or whatever they are called are coming back. And they will produce massive online open world Star Wars game. So I'm really curious what that will be. And yeah, I'm also a huge Star Wars fan and I just basically watched all the 7 Clone Wars episodes, seasons and now Rebels. So that's just a full... And that's why also the tattoo is coming from, like... Lord Vader is just here. Samurai Vader. Okay. So it might not be even that bad of a qualifying result today. As lots of the pro drivers are still struggling. Dan Terry is also struggling. Jason Daly is struggling. Paul Gatrix in the Ferrari. Pretty sure they are going out there with slicks. You're still finishing the Clone Wars, dude. You're in for a ride. Season 6 was awesome and Season 7 just blew my mind. It's just so beautiful to see it all coming together. You have a lot of time. I'm actually playing too much Cyberpunk right now, but I think I have to slow down because when they keep patching it, I don't want to basically have discovered everything. So he's already cooling. He might be on wet tires. So the dry tire pressures I set now are for 27-ish degrees. Yeah, you can nicely. So the bad thing is actually now the dry line will be gone again at the race start. So the first 3 or 4 laps we will be struggling. And then the question is for the second race, which will be in the evening. Very tricky, very tricky. Yes, Tico, I qualified P14 so far. I was at P9, I think. Now I'm 14 and the pro drivers are driving, but they are having a hard time as we can see. They are having a tough time. I'm again right in the middle of the 40 driver pack, so it's gonna be great. The British teabag is going to be soaked in German water. It sounds kind of wrong, but... Let's just relax and take it as a learning experience, like Domonkos just said. iRacing, yeah, I don't know, with so much, like, focusing on ACC is already a challenge. No one is driving BMW. It's a really unpopular car. It's really tricky to drive, I think, depending on the track, so... And yeah, iRacing is expensive. I just always hear that it's not as refined on force feedback, I think. Or is it probably better on force feedback? I don't know. They always say it feels so different. And yeah, it makes you spend a fortune. So I would really love to kind of drive another simulation. I'm just, you know, afraid because it's such a tough time already to practice ACC and kind of get to a good pace. It just needs so much time. Oh, that was close. And I even noticed that when I'm driving too much GT4 and then hop into a GT3 car that I'm struggling. So I think learning another simulation and the behavior there and then jumping into ACC, I think would just completely screw me over. Maybe it would help. I really don't know. I started with Race Room actually, but Race Room has the same with iRacing. You have to buy everything. And that's just, I don't like that approach. It's really tricky. Dan is still struggling. So 17 now. Serenity is on P8, nice. 17 from 42. So I'm still in the first half of the field. Force feedback is good, it just takes a little to get used to, okay. It's still like when I've really not looked into iRacing at all, which might be like a real capital crime as a sim racer, but do you get anything to like start with? Is there any package like you can start with? Do you get a car or a track, or do you really have to buy everything extra? I also hope that ACC stays around for a long time. I also hope they kind of expand it, because the game and the physics are so great, they should incorporate, like, I don't know, Super GT. It would be awesome to have Super GT cars there. Oh, spend over $100 on iRacing before you discovered ACC. Yeah. People were complaining about the DLCs costing money, and I was like, dude, it's just $10 and you get all or like with the GT4 pack, it was like $20 and you get all the GT4 cars. What? What's the problem? NASCAR and IndyCar, okay. NASCAR sounds fun actually, but yeah. I don't know, maybe in the not so distant future. You get out of. I just heard that iRacing, they have their own like safety rating version and it's kinda complicated. Tracks change every week, holy crap. If I ever get to the point where I can do sim racing for a living as a job, then maybe I can start iRacing as well. Right about now, I'ma just keep the focus on ACC. F1 feels like hot lapping, yeah. Ooh, so Dan is really struggling there in the wet, actually. Looks like we will stay with 17, that's fine. I don't know, Jorgen, I think they will just continue using the DLC model, and I think so far, I mean, they are not sharing any sales numbers, but I think it's working out well for them. The BMW is even bigger than the Bentley, I think. It's very long, it's very heavy, and because of the turbo lag, it kind of requires, I think, a bit of a different approach. So I just need to watch with 28. Let's see what the weather will be when we switch, but I guess slicks are mandatory. Just need to keep an eye on tire pressures. And the BMW is really, it's very long, it's heavy, and it has turbo lag, so you really need to drive it, like really push it, and I think it feels really heavy and slowish to get around corners. It's good on fast tracks, like I think on Monza you can fly with the BMW, but it's not that easy, and in terms of the balance of power, I think it's also not at the top, and yeah, it's just an unpopular car, although I think it looks awesome, and it kind of sounds really cool. It's just kind of a strange car that nobody really likes. That's interesting. Yes, Sam, I completely understand that. It's just really a shame when you can't play a game you would love to play because it's behind a paywall. That's why I'm kind of happy that there is like I don't know, I think it's a good to have like bonus content, but I think in terms of like all the loot boxes in other games, they kind of overshot that a little bit. So I think it's good to kind of like slow that down a bit. But yeah, Jorgen, we have to see. I have no idea how big Kunus is and how much money they make and whatever. They seem to be a pretty small team, actually. Domonkos shall conquer BMW. I want to see you drive the BMW. Prove it, Domonkos. Domonkos, come here. I'm gonna call you DK. Drift King. The BMW, you can surely drift. Mbam. Babaje in the Lexus. That's a difficult name. But very exotic. Cool to see. So what will we get? I think everyone will start on Slicks. Well, probably not everyone, but I think there will be a bunch of surprises. Oh, the MX-5 Cup sounds hilarious, actually. I think it's for, you know, having fun. It might not be. That's why I actually bought Project Cars 3, but it really didn't stick with me, unfortunately. The driving feels horrendous in the game. I think it's much better to drive with gamepad. Yeah, I agree actually with you, Jorgen. I think ACC is a very valuable game. The physics, the engine, everything is brilliant, and I think they need to build up on that. I think they need to expand that, but yeah, we have no idea what's going on behind the scenes. They basically threw out the 2020 DLC with nobody knowing about it, and we get a British DLC pack with the British tracks. Maybe there's another surprise coming, I don't know, but I would really love them to expand like on Super GT. I don't know, maybe Le Mans, European Le Mans series, something like that. Just not only the GT World Challenge, but since they are a licensed GT World Challenge game, I have no idea how they are with the contracts and stuff, you know. Okay. Tweedy in front of me with my livery. I shared the livery with him. So we have what we were afraid of. And let's just put in, click more pressure. And let's see what's happening, because I can adapt the pit pressures, and I should be fine with 45 liters of fuel in total. So let's see what we get here. Okay, looks good. Then you'd Zandvoort, I hope we get that as well, that would be amazing. Thank you, Jorgen. Oh, Sam, you're missing the start then. Come on, let's just stay for the start, dude. Yep, I think hard brake pedal is the key, Captain, because then you can just have a better feeling for it. Just take some time, but it's definitely going to help you, so that's cool. Cool to see everyone is upgrading, that's really cool. So P18 on Slicks, what can possibly go wrong? Yes, we are the twin Bentleys. I think we are the only ones who shared our custom liveries. By the way, Peter, I have not forgotten what we wrote about and discussed in terms of like a setup and stuff to do. I need to find my motivation. I need to catch it. It's like really, the last few days have been really just, you know, crazy. Wow. What's new with your students, Peter? Have they finished all their projects and videos and stuff like that? I would love to catch up on that actually at some point. Yeah, there's no need to change anything right now. Oh, awesome, Peter. 20 seconds. Looking forward to that. So what can possibly go wrong? Let's, yeah, use it as a learning experience. See what happens. I see myself in front. Oh boy. I still love how the new AMG looks. I just don't like how it drives. Come on, guys. Tires are cooling off. Come on. Do it. Do it now. Start. Oh, by the way, if you're wondering why my Mitchell mirror looks so different, I have a video about that on my channel. There are some hidden config settings you can use to calibrate that. Will be basically impossible to keep temperatures now in the tires. I think I even need more TC. I'm gonna take TC to the limit now for the first lap just because I want to be on the safe side. Because as you can see, there's so much water. Eight is probably too much. Eight is overkill. Get to the chopper! Come on, you need to get down. You push the pedal down. The world needs a new Schwarzenegger movie, really. I'm surprised there isn't one like Lockdown. Lockdown Returns. Return of the Lockdown. Halt zum Beinbruch. Danke, Domonkos. Thank you. Neck and leg break. That sounds so weird. Thank you so much, Manuel. Whoop. This is gonna be really crazy. So now with the slick tires, I bet other people are on slick tires. I have to be very defensive in the first lap. Very, very ultra defensive, actually. Just to make sure I can actually survive, because there will be a lot of sliding and a lot of understeering. Boy, I'm really afraid right now, because T1 will be... highlight video incoming, I guess. Just, I hope, without me. Thank you so much. Thanks for all the good luck wishes. I hope we can have a crash-free and exciting race. With a pit stop. 30 minutes with a pit stop. Where do you get that? Pressures are actually settling in really good. Just wow, I have no idea what's gonna happen now. It's going immediately to the middle there.
Car on the right, clear on the right. Car on the right, clear on the right.
Everyone was very, very careful there. Nice. Car on the left.
Car on the left. Clear on the left.
AMG behind me.
Car on the left. Clear on the left. Car on the left. Clear on the left.
Whew.
Car on the left. Clear on the
first
left.
First car's already off-road there. Everybody's ultra careful. I think everyone is probably on slicks at this point. Tweedy had a really good start there. Oh, contact. Nice. Could get through there. And ooh, Dan Terry behind me gets bumped. I've just passed 3 or 4 cars. Did you see that? No, just keep it on track. Whew. Nearly missed the mark there. Dan is now behind me. Need to be careful with Dan. He will be on the charge. Tricky, tricky now. Really establish a rhythm and a feeling for the car. Oh, it's so tricky. It's such a strange feeling to do that in slicks. I'm over careful right now because I'm just scared to lose the car.
There's a slow car ahead.
Ah.
Car on the right.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure. I'm wondering if Danny's on wets actually. Or if other cars are on bets, that would be really interesting to know. Nice and clean, yes, Tomonkos.
Car on the left. Clear on the left.
I'm just keeping it really clean and easy right now. I don't want to overdrive the car. Just have the feeling that the other guys are actually on wets. Or maybe I'm just too slow. That could also be. I'm just too careful right now. Pressures are actually a bit too high. So that's something to look out for. Whoop! But this setup is probably also not ideal for these conditions.
Well, I'm late. I'm so fast as now.
I was probably too early on brakes for him there. And he gets punted as well. Oh my god. Yeah, I'm really very, very careful right now because the car just feels too slippery. And probably my setup not the best for these conditions actually. And Jesus, guys, are you serious? What is going on there? I mean, am I too slow or they just can't drive?
Car on the right.
I think he completely missed his braking pointer.
Clear on the right.
That was just insane. So, it's gonna be interesting to see if they get any penalty for that. But yeah, I'm probably a bit too early on brakes for the geysers, just my feeling is not that good right now. But oh, okay, I think they're all struggling at the moment. Keep calm and carry on. Good plan. Just would love to know which tires they are on, actually.
Car on the right. Clear on the right.
I mean, look, he completely missed his braking marker and completely dive bombs. That's insane. It's usually my move. There will be a lot of people probably diving into the pits right now.
Yellow flag is sector one. Yellow flag, be careful. Slow car ahead.
And there's McLaren. Tweedy is in front of me. I'm pretty sure people are driving on wet tires. Because they're so fast right now. Pretty sure they are driving wet tires. I would be 5 seconds or no, 3 to 4 seconds quicker on wet tires. But the question is for how long? Oh, completely missed the mark there.
Yellow flag, be careful there. There's a slow car ahead.
Well, a bunch of people sliding around as well. Yeah, so going with dry tires, I'm not sure if that's the best decision, but the problem now is that I don't have tire pressures for wet tires. Everyone is faster than me. Dry tires was a mistake, I guess. I just can't go back to wets now because I have no clue about tire pressures.
Yellow flag in sector 3. Slow car ahead. Yellow flag ahead, be careful.
I mean, we could risk it for the next race, you know? Just set the pressures really low or something. Because they are all going to the right, they all have wet tires.
Losing to the car ahead is sector 1.
Love the Ducks shirt.
Yellow flag.
Yeah, so. Car on the left. Dry tires, bad decision. Well, you see that Harvey can't overtake me. It's just really tricky.
Car on the right. Clear on the right.
Yeah, now he got the better drive.
Car on the right.
Just wonder if I switch to wets now. What the pressures I need currently. We could experiment because the race is already screwed. I think something around 24-ish might be good. At least if I remember correctly, that was something that I had. Yeah, I just don't know about tire pressures. I think the right side has less tire pressures, right?
Yellow flag in sector 3.
Just gonna try it again now. Just gonna have my indicator out so that he knows I'm going into the pits. Okay, let's see. We have now the time to experiment with tire pressures. Let's see how much I messed them up. Because temperature is really high actually. Probably should decrease them even more. Okay, that was not optimal what I just did now. Oh, shit. Forgot to switch off the engine. So, how to not do a pit stop in the hectic like that. Let's just... I'm gonna do a screenshot of the tire pressures. Because I want to know for the next race. This was 28 degrees. So now we have the pressures of the white tires for 28 degrees. And we have like maybe an incline for the next race. Because... yeah, dry tires was a mistake.
tire pressure. Stay clear of the curbs.
Okay. Let's see how that goes. Well, now I know why everybody on the straight... Hey, Paddy, why everybody on the straight line was cooling the tires. Because they were all going with wets. Yep, that's a good pit... It was not a good pit stop, but it's nice that you can change strategy like that. Immediately grip feels much, much better. Let's see how long tires hold off. Just happy accidents by Bob Ross. Absolutely, Tom. Absolutely DK. I can use... I can completely change the setup. I can use brake pads 3 or 1. So the Schumacher S's are really tricky now. But the car feels already more stable. I mean not stable, but more grip on the tires. But yeah, as you can see, they are completely overheating right now. So that's the problem I was talking about. You either have to use pressures very, very low, or I don't know, no idea. Because the dry tires were definitely the wrong choice. Ducts are not fully open, but it's... We're gonna do that for the next race. Because my setup feels really good, actually. My setup... It's basically the dry race setup with wet tires, and it feels awesome, actually, now. It's just overcooking the tires.
Car on the left. Clear on the left.
Let's see what the first lap out of the pits will be. Brake pads 0, you mean no brake pads? I would brake pads 1 probably better than the 3s. Yeah, much, much better. Really looking, I'm really interested in the lap time right now. Bet he in front, is he dry or wet?
Well, mate, this has been
a 206. What was my last lap time? Didn't remember it. Is it like at least 2 or 3 seconds quicker now? So yeah, that's what we're definitely gonna use for the next race. Yep, definitely. We just need to lower... No, actually, pressures are fine. It's just the temperature. And the pressures are a tiny bit too low, but because of the temperatures. I have to drive off the line now, basically, on the straights, and cool them off. It's a bit tricky, 7 more minutes, I just hope they don't explode. But then again, I never had a puncture or exploding tire, so you go offline like this. And the tires are cooling off. Can immediately see that. And so not, you know, not braking that hard. And again cooling them off. So I'm now nearly 2 seconds quicker. I would be interested to know which tires he has, wet or dry, because he's struggling. How I approach braking. I brake fully and then slowly release the brakes. I don't know if you can see it on the bottom right, but that's just my try at trail braking, basically. Just kind of feel how the car rotates and lifting the brake more or less. And now I'm even braking earlier because of the Aston in front of me. He's braking really early in some of the turns, so I have to be very careful. See here, just a slight tap on brakes. And lifting brake pedal there. I'm also not always braking full, it depends on the track and the turn. But if you just watch the bars in the bottom right, you can see that. I mean, now it's tricky special conditions. Just trying to make him a bit nervous. Oh, losing a lot of time here. And again, cool off the tires.
Falling behind the car in front in sector 3.
So if I can just nail the pressures for the next race, we will be good to go. It's really important in this left-hander to release the brakes early.
Slow car ahead.
Not a slow car. Oh, what's happening? Oh, Serenity also seems to have a really bad race. He missed the mark there. Oh, and I nearly lose it.
Car on the left. Clear on the left.
Can I get a better drive there? Ah, it's just no chance to overtake here, and into the chicane it's generally a bad idea. Woo! He's jumping over there. I have to be careful now, because the tires are starting to slip and slide. So as you can see, they're getting red now. So I really need to open up the brake ducts. But the question is if I then want to use brake pads at 1 or 2. Oh boy, he's defending for his life. I need to find a way to improve pressures, but cool down the tires better. The Texas Range is behind me, not anymore.
Car on the left. Clear on the left.
Okay. Now I was in... Oh, he's damaged. That's why he's driving so... Okay. I thought I could make it stick, but... Not such a brilliant idea by me. I tried to force my way through, but... His Aston is huge damage in the front. You can see the hood and everything, so that's why he's struggling so much. I thought I could make the move there, but tires were not holding in the turn-in. Unfortunately, so not such a bright idea, but nothing happened. The Spinjala behind looked hilarious. Damn it, I didn't see that. So now that I was driving so fast, fuel is getting scarce, okay. One more lap-ish? Two more laps? So, how to nail the temperatures or pressures? Peter, do you have any suggestions maybe for pressures and temperatures? I'm concerned about using other brakes. Because the brake set 3 retains the temperature really good, but 1 might be better. 1 and then open the brake ducts to like 4? But then what about tire pressure? And we will be driving in the evening, so temperatures will be different. The struggle is real.
There's a slow car ahead. Yellow flag ahead. Watch out in front. The leader has finished the race.
Okay, that was our last lap. Nice. Good, I would have had fuel for another one, but... So, definitely the wrong decision to go with slicks. I would have expected the track to actually dry up more. But it looks like it's really raining. Not heavy, but also not light. It's like this medium stupid rain. I'm not just, you know, keeping my distance from Cobb to not crash him again. It's just camber, I have no idea now. It's just, I'm basically overwhelmed, Pete. And, yeah.
Got some light damage on the front of the car. Box this lap, we have to repair the car.
No grip on the rear tires. Absolutely no grip, you could see... Whoa. So, I don't think I can get that across the finish line, it's not steering anymore. Look at that! Yeah, I have no steering. Okay. So that's the first DNF of the season. And I'm even getting 5 STPs. Okay, so that's it, unfortunately. The real tires were completely overheating there. That's really tricky right now. So, what should I adjust now? I guess 4 and 3. Brakes 1. Hey Morten, you come in and I DNF, yes. No, that was just now really, the thing is now, how do we solve that? How do we solve that? These pressures were now for 28 degrees. Hey Archon. You're learning with me. Do you know Chatterjee's full name? No, I don't know actually. Do you know it? So the pressures are set now at 23.4, 23.4. These were the wet tire pressures I set. Oh no, shit, no, it's gone. Please, 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 please. Okay. So, and my pressures were actually every time below 30 degrees. Oh, you did have a good racing, Morten. That's nice to hear. Yes, I was actually more in the mood to drive my Camaro on Brands Hatch. Okay, he lives near you. The wet setup brake ducts are on 4 in the wet preset. I'm just not really concerned about the pressures, but since I can change tires and fuel consumption is actually also now, so lap time is 206-ish. What was my fuel consumption? 2.66. So, pressures should be somewhere like 22.9, 23. So these were like my pressures right now. These were the pressures at 28 degrees that I put on the pit stop, and I think they were too low. And what did Peter say? Peter says 43 liters. Peter says toe on back down to 0.2. And camber on front down. Thank you so much, Pete. Now it's just a question remains about tire pressures.
Alright, we have some wind conditions. Watch out for curves on exit and remember to brake early.
Now we have 20 degrees, so I guess I need more pressure, but that's really tricky right now. I just saved it here because I don't care about that. And then we just quickly check the wet preset. So the wet preset uses 3 and 2. That's actually 2. The get just gets the tired. No, we just have 1 qualifying and then 2 30-minute sprint races. And that's... Oh my god, look at that. So the wet preset just gives you crazy, crazy, crazy stuff. That's just too much. I need around about 45 liters. Round about. Well, I just love to fuel up a bit more, so let's just keep it like that. Oh god. What shall we do with tire pressures? The pressures were around 28.5 to 29, but tires were overheating, so I need to use more of the wet line. So, I mean, what is there to lose, you know? What's there to lose?
Don't DNF again, laughing face.
Morten, are you crazy? Thank you so much, mate. 20 euro. Wow, thank you so much. That's awesome. Don't DNF again. Okay, now I really have to put on the pressure. In the end, just full send. I'm really not sure with the I can adapt the pressures for the second pit stop, so let's just do that. That's just pure gambling right now. Pure gambling. And I'm taking brakes at 1. Should I really take brakes at 1? That's the dry brake set. I don't think so. I think I need to go with 3. Peter's at 3. Hey, Mims. Depends on how you define the fun. It's fun for the viewers, I guess. Oh, boy. Okay. So we need to keep an eye on the pressures now. And to not overheat. Yeah, wet preset. I think I need to go with 3, even though that's not the wet preset. I'm going with my dry setup because the track dries up immediately after like 4 laps. I mean, not immediately, but when in doubt, just go flat out. Hey Dean, you're new to ACC. Welcome to the community. Just, bro, that's actually tough to like answer. What are you struggling with the like handling of the car, force feedback? Just take it slow. Work on the consistency. Practice tracks. Don't like compare yourself to alien lap times, and just, you know, try to practice. Have a good time. Did I put on wet tires? Shit. I think I don't have wet tires on. Oh my god, look at that. I have dry set 4. I have dry set 4. That doesn't make any sense, guys. I will drive now with 20 PSI. But I can't change the setup now, can I? Oh god, I'm so stupid. How can... I'm so stupid. Look at that. Why did it change to dry? Okay, and yeah, basically my... Yeah, okay. I'm screwed. I need to immediately do a pit stop now. I'm so stupid. I need to do a pit stop with no refueling. Put on the wet tires. Yeah, that, but it doesn't, yeah, doesn't make any sense. Hooray! You see me messing up live on stream. How good is that? Yes, Mims, I'm an idiot. I'm a stupid beep idiot. That's because they were set to wet, and you know what happened? I was checking the wet preset, and then I was reloading my dry setup, and it didn't save the wet tires, or I forgot to set it.
Stay double file.
Don't go in? Are you sure? I can't drive with 20 PSI. You see that I have no brakes, nothing. I just can't. That's not gonna work. That's just not gonna work. Wow, Well, I'm gonna do a first lap and get lapped, and then I'm gonna... I should have entered pits now. Well, let's test it.
Green light, green light. Go, go, go. Car on the right. Clear on the right.
This is gonna be horrible.
Car on the right. Clear on the right. Car on the right.
I have to be very defensive now.
Car on the right. Clear on the right. You've got some light damage on the front.
Are you kidding me? This is the perfect example of how it should not go.
Car on the left. Clear on the left.
Oh my god, I should have went straight to the pits actually. I can't even hold the line there. Single player means just practice alone, not do the career mode. The career mode is just this very crazy. Jesus, I can't even turn the car in. It's horrible. Why did I not change to wet tires? Why? Oh
right.
My god, that's horrible.
Clear on the right. Car on the right.
I'ma just do...
Clear on the right.
Oh my god. The problem is if I pit now and it then changes the pit strategy, I need to reset the pressures again. There are a bunch of crashes now.
Yellow flag in sector 1.
Just so not good. So I'm basically that's last place, but yeah, that's how it goes, everyone. That's the prime example of what can happen in the hectic of a race. So pit strategy 1. I'm fueling up completely right now to just get it over with, and I can go back to pit strategy 1 actually. I just can change the tire set, right? So yeah, let's do it like that. Far. No, Morten, that's just, I couldn't hold the car. I would lose like 20 seconds per lap, and that's just, that doesn't make any sense. I could potentially also ruin the race for others there, so Dean, you can actually set the single player as safety rating if you want it to track or not, so you can actually also deactivate it. But if you watch my beginner's guide series, I explain a lot of the settings and stuff, so that might solve some of the questions. And do not compare yourself to like all the quick lap times. Yes, just keep your focus on like settling in at your pace and improving, and learning a track is more important, you know. Just learn a track, feel comfortable on the track.
Come on, go, go, go. Low tire pressure, stay clear on the curbs.
So everybody's coming up behind me right now. Good. At least we are not lapped. Hey, Harry! How did it go? I'm really looking forward to Tuesday, actually. I really wanted to participate in the race, but yeah, ACCSS is in the way. Oh, really good that... you guys had a blast. That's a good sign, actually, that everybody is kind of, you know, learning and having fun in Sim Racing XP, so that's good. That's good to see. Whoa. Now let's get these wets on temperature. Yeah, might have been a mistake, Mim, so, but it's just the race is ruined anyway. I love my abbreviation, by the way, boo. So let's just file that as learning experience, but yeah, when you practice on the practice server for the whole week and it's always dry, and then you get this, it's just a bit too much stress for me at this point, because I don't have the experience. So I really then don't know what tire pressures to set, and then you absolutely see in the hectic I make a stupid mistake like I did. Dude, it's a bit too aggressive probably. Need to be careful there with the wet. But nevertheless, look at how they are overheating. It's just insane. Red and white numbers. In the split we have... So in this league we are racing, we have amateurs who are a red number plate and pros who are the white number plate. So we have two splits within the league that we are racing in. And our silver league has dynamic weather, unfortunately, yes. But not the practice server. Because there's just one practice server for all three leagues. They have static weather on the practice server, and that's, yeah, kind of bad. Because you can't be prepared for the race then. But I always, it's really tricky, these conditions. That's why I prefer full wet rain. I have no problem with a full wet race. Because you just set your tires and everything and you're done. But you see, that's the tricky, it's just not raining enough, and it's too warm for wet tires, actually. But it's also not good for dry tires, as we have witnessed in free practice. But yeah, that's just the struggle of dynamic weather. And that was the good thing with SimGrid, their practice servers are set like the race. So for like our Misano race, we could have, we basically had 10 different setups and pit strategies prepared. And then Marcello messed it up at the start with giving us a drive-through, two drive-throughs. So yeah. I forgot to cool my tires now. Will not forget to use the wet. See, everyone learned something from me right now. That's so good that actually there's always something to learn. I just show you how many layers there are to this simulation, how much you have to be, you know, pay attention and be careful. That's just crazy. That's actually what makes it so fascinating. So for tomorrow's split, don't forget wet tires if it rains. So stupid. It would have potentially worked out really well, actually, if I look at the pressures right now. I actually don't want to change any of the pressures right now, because I don't really see much sense in it, because temperatures is really high. The race is a sneaky beginner guide, absolutely. Showcasing what can go wrong in sim racing. Showcasing when you take a British teabag into German waters. It's probably a good highlight, my facial expression when I noticed I'm having dry tires, like... Wow. I've again forgot to cool my tires. Jesus. Wow. This race is gone, it's gone, it's gone, it's gone. I messed it up completely and start to sing. And I was feeling so good on the practice server. I did new personal best times in the drive with the Bentley. And I thought to myself, yes, this is gonna be a really cool race. And then you hop onto the server and it's rain and you're like, oh God, no. I'm not last anymore, yes. Woohoo! Need to put the 20 euros to some good news for Martin. But I need to pit anyway. Because the mandatory pit stop did not count. And I'm probably just get it done now. Or not now, I just... need to set the strategy again. Jesus. So let's just do this. Let's hope that works. It's the same on tires, yeah. Thanks, Pete. It's a long way to go, yes. Are they changing the tires now? Yes. Yeah. Yeah, I think I could be fine in top 10, top 12 actually, if I would have selected wet tires. Oh my god.
Mandatory stop is now clear. Come on,
what?
Let's go.
Why is it sometimes messing up the ignition? Just push the ignition. Still not last. Oh great, now all the leaders are coming through.
Slow car ahead.
Wow, I'm racing in the top 20, woohoo! I had a 205. Was my best time here. And look at their pace. I can actually keep up with them. So yeah, I completely messed up. I completely killed my race. That's just an easy pace they're running. Can stay with them. And I'm just fresh out of pits. And look, one car goes wide, three other cars go as well. Ah, hilarious.
Car on the left. Clear on the left.
So, yeah, I so killed my own race. I would have been top 10. Or not.
Faster car coming up behind you.
I don't even know what to say anymore. I don't even know what to say. anymore. That's just not my day. That's just absolutely... I would just... I'm so sorry, but right now I would just like love to log off because... I'm just... That's just not my day today. I was feeling really bad at the beginning of the stream. And it's just... I can't... Yeah. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry that you have to watch this. I'm absolutely not happy with what's happening right now. But as I always say, there's a good side to everything, so you should just keep going and file it as a practice. But yeah, I have to apologize for everyone here. That's just not the show I wanted to give you tonight.
Yellow flag ahead. Be careful. Slow car ahead. Faster
car
coming up behind you.
Really not the show I wanted to give you guys. I mean, there are a lot of people struggling. Fabian through there. Serenity is in P2 and class P5 overall. Nice. She had a huge crash, I think, in her first race. And was last, I think. So she also had a bad time. So it's good to see that she has a better experience now, at least. Better than mine.
Yellow flag in sector one.
So stupid. Yeah, Peter, that's racing. It's just... It's my own stupidity. And I really, as I was saying in the beginning of the stream, just today is such a bad day for me. But the stream is always kind of lifting me up. And I'm so happy that at least you guys are still sticking with me, but... It's just... abysmal today what I'm doing. It's just horrible. So, yeah. There's not even any sense to like push right now because I should not irritate the guys in front. The guy's passing me. Serenity is doing her pit stop now, I think.
Faster car behind you.
I have no idea why I lost the car there. Maybe I was too close to the garage or something. Oh, Laszlo, yeah, okay. That's very unfortunate.
Car on the right. Clear on the right.
I'm just letting them through. I don't want to irritate them.
Clear on the right.
Ooh, I didn't see Paul there. Sorry, Paul. He was not on my radar. My radar. Raider of the Lost Ark. That's something different. There's just sometimes you have one of these days where you don't want to wake up. Reminds me of my childhood listening to Limp Bizkit. Tuesday will be more awesome. I'm really looking forward to Tuesday with Sim Racing XP. Always cool. Mixed race at Brands Hatch with the muscle car Camaro. I'm going back to the Camaro because the McLaren just... I don't know what it is with mid-rearranging cars, but they just don't like me. I'm not able to drive them as precise as I have to really push them. So it looks like I'm stuck with front-engine cars. Until I get better. And the Camaro just feels more forgiving to drive. It's a bit more on the softer side and... Oh boys, GT4 worth the buy. I absolutely love GT4 cars, but unfortunately people don't really drive them. So, but they're so much more enjoyable because even though they are not that slow, they are a bit more relaxing to drive because you can react better to what's happening. So I would actually, if you just can spend the money, I would definitely buy it and give them a try and really race them in mixed races. So much fun. But yeah, as Morten says, you really need to find a league where you can either drive GT4 only or GT4 mixed races. But Morten, I think we have a league, right? So I'm racing in ACCSS and Sim Racing XP, and Sim Racing XP is a brilliant beginner community. They are expanding massively with their own server structure and also support from Sim Racing GP as their platform to organize the races. So Morten, feel free to post the Discord link to Sim Racing GP in the chat. Anyone who is like looking for a racing league that's beginner friendly and has a mixed grid and puts emphasis on a mixed grid, just check out Sim Racing XP. We are racing on Tuesday and I'm so much looking forward to that. GT4 power. And I think Sim Racing XP is actually one of the only league I know currently who does mixed races, which does mixed races. Everyone is either not doing mixed races or just has GT4 only. Or no GT4 at all, so that's like, even in SimGrid daily races, I was trying to get into some GT4 races, but there were barely any people signed up. Yeah, exactly, Mims, that's true. I think finding a league is crucial to the experience. Public races, public lobbies are just so frustrating. Oh, I'm back in last place, actually. Back in last place. Sound of the Maserati. I need to do like a Maserati only cup or something. Because the Maserati is insane. To pass. Don't irritate with two guys fighting there. You can jump into Sim Racing XP at any point, and there's just a sign up at Sim Racing GP for the next races. So I think Morten or Peter, anyone, just link the Discord to Sim Racing XP. I don't have it in here. Sim Racing XP is the wave to go for you guys then. So then we can race against each other. I'm just like go into the pits and talk with you guys. So one thing we need to make clear for Sim Racing XP is actually please don't ever do these weather conditions, they're just awful. So I'm, yeah, the two worst races of my career so far, I guess. It's just, what can you do? Stuff like that happens. I just continue for like the fun of it. Thanks, Pete. So that's the Sim Racing XP League. The only awesome mixed racing league out there, guys. Check it out. I prepared a few of the steering wheel for you guys, so that you can see what's happening, what I'm doing, because you don't see the whole thing, and I kinda got used to it. So I'm actually doing this for the stream, that you can see how much I'm steering and everything that's going on, because just there's such a tiny webcam picture with my steering wheel on it.
There's a slow car,
and I really kinda, I don't know, when I disable it, something's missing. Because I don't see it anyway. It aligns perfectly with my steering wheel. So the screen is like right about there. And whenever I steer it in, I don't see it. So it's really cool, actually. It's not irritating. And it kind of, I don't know, enhances the immersion. But yeah, you're right. I could deactivate it, but I just, I'm so used to that right now. I think it's cool for you on stream. Ooh, the Aston there looks damaged as hell.
Faster car behind you.
Ooh, not last anymore. Nice. 900. I think. Or is it set to automatic? I don't know. I think it's 900. No, I set it to since it is 900. Yes, 900 degrees. I think that's recommended for ACC, right? Harry drives with bonnet cam. Harry drives with bonnet cam. That's bold to say out loud in front of a bunch of simulation guys. Everybody point fingers on Harry. He's driving with bonnet cam. Boo! Oh, no, I'm just joking, Harry. You see more, but I don't know. I love this. This is the immersion feeling. If I would have space, I would use triple screens. Because the immersion is so cool with triple screens. I should have not said that, Harry. Now everybody knows it, Harry. There is no escape. There is no hiding from the simulation gang. The simulators, not the terminators, the simulators will find you and hunt you down. Simulators, Chompment Day. Slash block. Dirty Harry, that's a good one. Bonnet cam Harry. Harry, we're just joking around, so don't take it personally, please. I need something to lighten up the mood. If you enjoyed more and you're faster than I am, then please absolutely go with bonnet cam. It's a new challenge. How fast can I go and not get last? Yes, I have that enabled with the look into the direction. I just scaled it down, but he's narrowly looking where I'm going. I just really scaled it down because it can be irritating on some tracks. It makes it look like the car is drifting when it's not or something. So look with, I think it's called look with the wheel. And I also have the horizon lock activated. Tweety is behind me. Just let my twin Bentley pass. He's doing good. He's in 12th. Nice. I could be with him there. I could be with him. So cool that we use the same livery.
Yellow flag. Yeah.
New subscriber in a one country just from here. Sorry. Tweety is doing really good in 11th now. Oh, Super GT is so cool. Can we have Super GT in ACC, please? Slow me down if you... Yeah, come on, Harry. Sit on my bonnet. and just be my race engineer while sitting on the bonnet. That would actually be really cool. Like, watch out, it's wet. Oh, finally, it's over. I don't say that often, but it's just really glad that it's over. And oh, I'm 34th out of 36. Woo-hoo-hoo. Just don't know why I lost the car in this. The track looks nearly dry right now. That's so irritating, but it's actually not. Can still spin, absolutely I can. Every time I say, oh this looks fine, I can have the pace.
Alright, checkered flag, good job, you did the best you could. I'll bring the car back.
Ah, it's over. What a mess. That was just horrible. Why did I take dry tires? Why did it not change to white? I don't get it. Okay, looks like Serenity was also not keeping her fifth place. So these are just conditions that, yeah, I don't really like, as you can probably tell. So anyway, I started spinning. Yeah, better penalty and better ranking system would be cool. Overall, also the multiplayer part and everything, it would be so much cooler. Like, let's just quickly check the livery again. That I just love it. That was so cool. Sometimes the simplest ones are the best looking ones. And on Tuesday, you will see my Pennzoil Camaro that I already shared. Let's just take a look at the Pennzoil here. And it's not a German livery. That's just the color that it has. And just on the rear I put when in doubt go flat out, but I also got another suggestion on Discord, I think, but I really liked it. The simpler you do it, the more it looks like a race car, you know. And that's the fun thing, actually. Sometimes, you know, I tend to overdo it, like even though I like it, it's just not a typical race car livery, but I think I love it. It looks fantastic, but it's just too much for a race car. And the GT4 is just, this one is based on the Le Mans livery from Aston, actually, because I did the V12 Aston like that, and I just basically copy pasted it, and it looks really better with orange rims. I did not believe that. So this is like a Le Mans livery they used in 2008 or 2009 for Aston Martin, actually. And it's just so cool because it's like so basic and it looks like a race car. And this one was actually a retro livery I saw on Google. So the original Pennzoil was used for the Nissan for the R34 GTR, I think. And it's like black with yellow and some stripes and stuff. So I may even do that like as a variation. But right now, since I think I will put the focus on the Chevy GT4 for sim racing XP, I'm actually looking on finding other cool like Camaro liveries. But there are not many. Most of them, I think, are from NASCAR. So I might even do it like a NASCAR livery, but because the car, it just looks like a NASCAR. Lambo is really tricky, John. Bentley is a bit more planted. John, the suggestion would be actually to get in a racing league. Just practice the tracks and race with other people. Find a beginner racing league, like for example, Sim Racing XP. But don't practice like alone. Also practice with the AI from time to time. Like practice quick races, follow the AI. Try to get a feeling for race situations and stuff like that, you know, so that you are not always alone. Because when you race alone, there's like this tricky thing that happens that you don't get a feeling for how to behave with like other cars and stuff like that, you know. So Let's just get it down to one, everything. So that's like, I think I talk about it in like my beginner's guide series, part two or part three, how to like practice tracks and what to do. So give that a try as well. What car do I drive in real life? I actually don't really drive. It's more my girlfriend that does the driving. I'm more the motorcycle guy. So I actually just own a motorcycle, an Aprilia. And my girlfriend and myself, we own an Audi A3 from 2011, I think. So just the standard A3 with like 100 something horsepower. So that's around it. And if you would ask us, I think we would rather have something along the lines of like, I don't know, a Hellcat or something. Nah, just like I don't know. I really love the Dodge Challenger, for example, is a nice car, but also like Audi RS3, BMW M4, something along these lines, but that's just too expensive. So we stick with our motorbikes. So we both have motorbikes, Italian motorbikes. She drives Ducati, I drive Aprilia, and that's actually our motorsport passion. And with all the cars are just so expensive that we'd rather just, you know, watch them get tuned and look at them. Just like we are watching the German guy, JP Performance. I don't know if anyone knows him, and he's currently working on a Mazda RX-7. Brilliant car, and the Toyota Supra, like the classic one. And the Nissan with the RB26 engine. So that's like actually the passion would go actually in this direction, but we don't have the space, we don't have the money. And so we rather just do our motorbike tours in the summer and watch other people tune cars. And John, you can race in leagues on Xbox as well, I think, and as well against computer and stuff like that. And just switch that. So that didn't go as planned today, but I think some people, no, not a Bugatti, Bugatti Chiron. I want a Fiat Multipla. Yeah, probably. And then make it really wide. Nissan Micra. You are just so funny, guys. Honestly, I would actually go for my personal, I don't know, it's really hard to say. I don't like manual cars. So for me, it would have to be something with like semi-automatic clutch or something like this here with shifter pedals. It's really hard to say. Problem is cars are just too expensive. I would probably go with a Mercedes. With like the new A, Mercedes A, AMG. I don't know them exactly, but they look really cool. What I kind of like in cars is when they look sporty and futuristic, but and the inside is clean and futuristic, like touch screen and everything's digital. I love that. But I wouldn't go electric for now. I think that's just still not where it should be. Electric mountain bike with a dog trailer. Hey, Domonkos, thank you so much, mate. That's very much appreciated. Still entertaining to watch. Goal achieved. That's like the goal for every stream. It should be entertaining and you should learn something. And I think we learned a huge load actually today. Always check which tires that you're going to use when it's raining. Oh my god. I really need to check the stream replay of like my facial expression when I noticed. I was like, why is pressure dropping to 22 and not 21? Where tire pressure should go up. And then it was like, oh god, no. Educational sim. That's like, we have a hashtag for that. Unfiltered sim racing. Yeah, retrograde. I mean, if we would have a really cool infrastructure for electric cars, like imagine you could charge them while driving on the highway. You just go on the highway into the most right lane and induction charge up your electric car. And the energy comes from wind, sunshine, whatever, from nature. I mean, or like we finally master fusion reactors and can have unlimited energy with the power of the sun or whatever. I'm just talking futuristic right now. Then I would say like, yes, cool, take electric, even autonomous cars. Let them just drive. But always like another ka-ching. John, thank you for the video and the feedback. Awesome. Thank you so much for the super chat. Very much appreciated. Like F-Zero, exactly. You charge them up and then you get the turbo boost. But I know that's like the tricky thing is about cars. Some people use them to get from A to B, and some people use them because they're like an, how to say, like an expansion of their soul, of their personality. They drive cars for a passion. And I think that's like, as long as we don't get over that, kind of the thing is, that's kind of, do we want to get over that? I'm getting completely philosophical right now, but bear with me. It's like, most people are against like electric cars and everything because it's like not puristic, or like we still see cars as more than they actually are. And I think if we as people don't kind of get over that challenge that, you know, cars are just to get from A to B sort of transportation, it doesn't really matter what you have as long as it's like cheap and environmental friendly, as long as we don't kind of understand that, there won't be any progress, because still cars are like, yeah, it's hard to explain. I get it, and that's the tricky part to tackle, so that kind of, I don't know, people find something else. And I think that's just gonna take some generations. We already see kind of the change right now. I think that young people don't really get into cars like they did like 20, 30 years ago. And so everything's changing right now, and then we are still here, we the petrol heads, and like, yes, we love race cars and everything. It's just like, I think at some point that will change, and once it changes we can progress. And yeah, that's just, but ultimately, if you just keep on reading social media and everything, it's even though when they test electric cars and they're like, well, how fast can it go to a 60 mph or 100 kilometers per hour, and how fast, and I'm like, it doesn't absolutely matter. It's like electric cars, it should be about like how cheap are they and where can you go with it and stuff like that. But it's still, we keep the focus on speed, and yeah, that's something we kind of need to learn and evolve. And Jesus, I'm doing now rambling philosophical car stuff. So anyway, someone's still there in chat, people already dropping out, like, oh my god. Losing subscribers now. What he's talking about? Unsubscribe. That sounds kind of fun. There's also, no, I'm still don't get it why cars are so damn expensive. They produce the next Mercedes or the next BMW, and it's even more expensive than the last one. And I'm like, dude, it's the same material. What, I mean, what are you paying for? It's plastic and metal. I mean, why does a car have to cost like 70, 80, 100,000 euros? That's just insane. Pete, all good. So yeah, I think if we talk about like future of cars and transportation, it has to change, because it just, it's not... yeah, the roads are getting fuller and fuller, and transportation, I think at some point we'll come to a limit. So it will change for sure, but as long as we can have combustion engine race cars, I think we are fine. Inflation and devaluation, yeah, absolutely. But what paper currency? I mean, everything is digital right now. We just have plastic money. Check the server setting early in the week. Yes, Mims. It's just, the guys were discussing yesterday if it will be raining or not, and nobody wasn't, you know, nobody was really sure if it will be full rain or just wet and no rain. So yeah, people still here. Good. Yeah, Dom Onkos. That's just, I think in urban areas that really needs to change. It's like here in Vienna, you don't need a car. Honestly, you just don't need it. It's just to visit someone, and you're lazy, because of course you can maybe be there faster, depends on the traffic, but usually you're, depends on where you go, you're faster with public transport. But it's just when you go shopping or you go abroad or you drive out of the city, of course a car is cooler. But if you basically live in the city and just need to go to shop for groceries and are not planning to travel, you don't really need a car. But in situations like that with the lockdown, I understand why people preferably sit alone in the car than go with public transport. Yeah, the server setting was 20% rain, but the practice server was not. And yeah. I thought, okay, when it's raining, I use the wet preset, and then I was fiddling around with the dry tires. That was the mistake, actually. So I should have just stayed with wet tires and not mess around, and everything would have been fine, but anyway. And the practice was dry all the time, yes, because they used a bronze setting, I think. OSM, yes, I absolutely agree. People still have it too good, at least in Europe, where people can just afford huge cars, and cars get bigger and bigger, by the way. That would change at some point, I think. We might be at that kind of border right now. We are kind of starting to cross that line if the lockdown and pandemic stuff continues like that. It's gonna be an interesting time ahead, so that's why we do sim racing. We stay at home and drive in rain. Yeah, Mims, it was depressing. Yeah, yeah, but anyway, it wasn't not a good day today. I really was one of my bad lockdown days today. Not really in the mood for anything. So again, I'm sorry for the abysmal performance, but I'm so glad for the donations, guys. Thank you so much. And for the continued support, very much appreciated. So that lifted the spirit again. And let's settle in for tonight. Really cool to talk with you all, to chat with you. And I'm back on Tuesday. Mixed race with sim racing XP. And on Thursday, multi-class race with the sim grid. Both races with the Camaro. So that will definitely be some action. And you were seeing one of my cats today, for sure. Yeah, she was sitting right in front of the camera. So if you missed it, start to the beginning of the stream. That was actually hilarious. Oh yeah, Mims, absolutely, in a rain race. And I was just fiddling around too much. I was experimenting with slick tires. I was experimenting with this. I couldn't get settled into any setup. So I really, really off to a bad start. It's the same with Bathurst. If you're not feeling good for Bathurst, you can just screw it, yeah. Watcher, it was awful. Both races were just awful. But nevertheless, it was a cool show. No camera change from the cat today. Yes, that's because I moved the keyboard now off limits. I need to really show you the setup within the next few weeks. How I basically change everything from my home office to my racing and what I'm doing. And I need to do that. So I'm just signing off now. That's enough for today. So I hope I see you all on Tuesday. Remember to stay safe. Take care of each other. Be careful. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you for the donations. If you still enjoyed it, click some thumbs up. That would be very much appreciated. And have a good night, everyone. I'm signing off. See you soon. Bye-bye. Take care.